Betelreeve Tanalina requests your presence at the Royal Palace. There is a situation developing, and you have come highly recommended, or so we have been led to believe. There are eager ears everywhere, so keep your voice low. The situation involves Sea Slode. The Betelreeve has been informed that you dispatched one of the foul creatures. I find that implausible, but as a lowly squire, my opinion doesn't matter. I can tell you that the Betelreeve sent three adventurers and a squad of marines to determine the extent of the problem. After an initial report, contact with the group was lost. What the Betelreeve will ask of you, well, that's for her to impart.
Trapped. Which one could he possibly be?
Brothers and sisters, you look at one another and expect...
I have no time to deal with whatever issue concerns you, newcomer. I recently received word that all of Somerset faces an imminent threat from a source we believed had disappeared long ago. Of course, you must be the newcomer the Queen's Cat told me about. If you really killed a sea slowed, then you might be just what I need to keep the situation from completely spinning out of my control. Will you help defend Somerset? A group of adventurers volunteered to investigate the possible incursion. I received a single report that indicated they were making progress, but that was the last I heard from them. Kynar, Grog, and Miria seem capable enough, but sea slowed. The mage Kynar radiated an air of confidence, as did the Red Guard Maria. They seemed extremely competent. The orc, though, Grog, I think he called himself, appeared to be in a constant state of inebriation. Drunk! He was as intoxicated as a Nord on festival day. I took a chance because the situation seemed desperate, and by the stars it appears that I'm going to do so again. For all our sakes, I hope you don't disappoint me too. Frankly, I thought sea slodes were just a myth. Other than the report from Razumdar, I have no solid evidence of this so-called incursion. That said, the disappearance of Kynar and the marines I sent out has given me cause for concern. The mage Kynar radiated an air of confidence, as did the Red Drunk! Without more information, there's no target to attack. Besides, I don't have an army at my disposal right now. The majority of our forces are committed to the continent and the Three Banners War. I must rely on the forces at hand.
Yeah. Hail, mighty warrior! Hail, mighty warrior!
Death in...
A thousand curses on you, Madha!
haven't you, Lord?
Well then, it appears that your mission has thus far been a success. Since you're here, I could use your help. My associate Grog has been captured. I need you to free him, while I try to learn everything I can about the Seaslode called Khadgarza. Grog went off to investigate the undead near the bay. Figured they were the Seaslode's handiwork. He didn't account for the smugglers, though, and they captured him. Now he's chained up as a gift to appease Khadgarza, the Seaslode necromancer. I appreciate the effort. While I may have dealt with a few of these scoundrels, I'm not capable of eliminating an entire army of smugglers. Besides, one of us has to investigate Khadgarza and the other Seaslodes. Somerset is depending on us. As quietly and efficiently as I possibly can, I have no desire to get into additional altercations with either the smugglers or the Seaslode's undead servitors. I'll meet you back here in this relatively safe location once we're both finished. From what I've been able to observe, the smugglers have entered into some kind of arrangement with the Seaslode. They occasionally leave prisoners for the creature to toy with. Unfortunately, Grog is just the latest in a long line. A hunch, I suppose. For an often inebriated orc, he actually excels at that sort of thing. From what limited knowledge I have of the Seaslodes, though, necromancy appears to be one of their favorite pastimes. I'll try to learn more once you depart.
Hello? Someone there? Are you one of those double-dealing smugglers? I'm going to take a chance and assume you're not, because I really need you to get me out of these chains. You know, before the big slug notices me. How do I... What the tusk do I look like? A blacksmith? Sorry, let me consider. Well, the smuggler with the key went to chat with the Slode. Said something disagreeable, and I heard him scream. Body's not far. Or if you can pick a lock. Sure, I'll tell you everything I know. Right after you get me out of these chains. Look, I'm tired, I'm thirsty, and I'm in no rush to have that slimy slug get its webbed fingers on me. So go get that key.
Servants, crush all who oppose me!
Thanks for getting me out of those chains. My wrists were starting to chafe. So, what's the plan? How do we get out of this oblivion pit? Look, I'm grateful and all that, and I really admire your tenacity, but we're not safe here. I'll tell you and Kynar everything I learned right after we get out of this place. Fine, but then we really need to get out of here. The Sea Slode's name is Kagarza, some sort of necromancer based on all the undead I ran into. But that's not all. I heard it talking to someone. A high elf, I think, said some interesting things. Something about a cabal of some sort, multiple Sea Slodes working together. They discussed another one of the big slugs operating to the south. Said they had a way to sink the island. Can we get out of here now, please?
Let's
thanks for retrieving Grog. He may be lazy, perpetually intoxicated, and a terrible cheat at ancestor draw, but he is one of my steadfast companions. Was he able to shed any additional light on the Seasloat menace? Interesting. That corresponds with what I was able to learn. Anything else? My drunken companion usually discovers the most tantalizing secrets. Sink the island? Magic of that sort sounds as remarkable as it is terrible. Maria and the High Elf Marines headed south, following rumors of some sort of natural phenomenon. I wonder if they're related. You need to go help her. Time is of the essence. While you go south to aid Maria, I'll return to Alinor and bring what we've learned so far to the Battle Reeve. It splits our forces, but I don't see any other way. Good luck, and may the stars light your path.
Whoever you are, if you aren't an illusion, you need to take word to Alinor. Tell Battle Reeve Tanerline. The Marines, we followed rumors of some new kind of magic, discovered the geysers. Seasloat magic, something to do with abyssal pearls. The geysers spout terrible sea creatures and undead. Bokorgan. The Seasloat is working to increase their power. Our report contains all the details. The High Elf Marine in Dirim, he's a mage, though nowhere near as powerful as Kynar. He compiled notes about the geysers, most of which I didn't understand. When the Yagra attacked, we split up. The Marines headed down the coast. I should survive. I've suffered similar injuries in the past. As soon as I gather my strength, I'll make my way back to Alinor. You saw Queen Iren step out of the orrery? What a wondrous thing.
You're back. Kynar returned and said you went in search of Maria and the Marines. Tell me, is the sea slowed threat as dire as the Queen's Cat intimated? Eight protect us! A cabal of sea slowds, high elf traitors, magic geysers that can sink the island. I ask you to look into one threat, and you bring me a multitude. Still, this confirms the rumors. Now that we know, we can plan accordingly. Normally, I'd dispatch every soldier at my disposal to deal with these geysers. However, the ongoing war has depleted our forces. It might be time to reach out to more people like you and Kynar's adventurers. For now, take this with my thanks. The work you did... Somerset requires your services again, friend of Razumdar.